feed my sheep. What he was saying to Peter was that you're not lost. I got stuff for you to do. And what Peter didn't understand was that everything that he went through in his life was for the purpose of helping other people. Peter, do you think Peter was ever judgmental again? Do you ever think he said, I can do it better than him? I bet he never was judgmental again. Because he knew only by the grace of God was he able to do anything. And when he saw somebody else fall, Peter was not judgmental. He brought the compassion that Jesus Christ gave to him. So if you look at this story this morning, what does it say to us? And we'll finish up here. What does it say to us this morning? Well, first of all, looking at yourself, in the past, you may have wept bitterly sometimes. You may have had a fall, and you wept bitterly. Maybe right now, you're in the midst of a fall, and you're weeping bitterly about it. You're broken about it. Maybe in the future, you will weep bitterly. Well, this story tells us that Jesus is coming to you this morning. Say, hey, look, I'm praying for you. And when you get it all together, I got stuff for you to do. I got people for you to help. You're not so far gone that Jesus can't use you. And then it tells one other thing. This is the last thing I want to look at this morning. Go with me in your Bible. One more scripture and we'll be through. Go to Luke chapter 22, verse 61. Luke chapter 22, verse 61. Luke chapter 22, verse 61. And we'll have our new group coming up. Look at verse 61 of Luke chapter 22. And the Lord turned. This is the same part we left off in Matthew. Luke tells a little bit more about it. And the Lord turned and looked upon Peter. And Peter remembered the word of the Lord, how he had said it to him, before the cock crow, thou shalt not deny me thrice. When he saw the Lord's eyes on him, he did not see condemnation. He saw compassion. He saw grace. That was Jesus. That was the body of Christ looking at Peter. We are the body of Christ. You know that? We need to understand that we need to have that same look. We need to have that same look because we now are the body of Christ. When we see somebody going through these fishermen's five steps, we need to, it may be a family member. It may be a friend. It may be a member of this congregation going through these five steps to take a fall. We need to tell them something. We need to do it. We need to tell them we're praying for you. We're praying for you. We're praying for you. And when you're okay, when you come back, the Lord will use you.